XL Energy Center was one of hockey's toughest venues. Tonight, the Wild are back in front of their fans, hoping that trend continues with a win against visiting Columbus Blue Jackets.
And a long shot deflected back up in the high slot. Winnick's pass across too far for Cullen. Jackets back on the attack. A centering pass intended for Calvert was broken up by Brodin. Plays it back to Wennberg. His shot deflects off a skate. Eric Sinek plays it to safety. Knocked out to center by Spurgeon. Eric Staal in for Minnesota. Saved by Bobrovsky. Bobrovsky has been outstanding so far this season. Mitchell tries to force it out to center. It comes back into the corner. Brodin has it there. His pass across, too far for Olofsson, and a quick backhand chance stopped by Dubnyk. Battle in the corner. Zucker emerges with the puck for Minnesota. Tried to get it to Koivu, who is breaking toward the net. Intercepted by Jones, who carries back the other way. Stewart deflects to the corner. Staal threw it out front. Stewart was driving toward the net. Dumba to Staal behind the net. Good stick work by Staal. Centers for Eric Sinek. Saved by Bobrovsky. Savard coming off of an outstanding season where he finished at plus 33. Dubnyk hugging the post, hangs on, and we're going to have our first penalty of the game. Columbus onto the power play. Minnesota has allowed a power play goal in each of their first three games, four total. Koivu works his way in. Koivu shorthanded with a shot and a save by Bobrovsky.
Nice move here. He knows he's got a little bit of time, and he figures, I'm going to take this all the way. Worst case scenario is it's got to come back 200 feet.
Only players in the league that had a better plus minus were Minnesota's Ryan Suter and Jason Zucker, who tied for the league lead at plus 34. Staal driving the net, he scores!
Bobrovsky hinges down with the glove and he goes up top with a very nice move. Walks the elbow in and Staal sees an opening. What a beautiful goal.
I was watching him skate this morning at the Wild's morning skate, and it makes everything look so effortless. Speaking of effortless, how about this? Great passing, puts the puck on the stick to Voritsky, and he has nothing but empty net.
If you don't cross the line, how do you know where it is?
You'll know it well by the end of the night. A tipped shot out front and a sliding save by Dubnyk.
And right there, Dubnyk just stays very calm and doesn't give up a rebound.
He's with the club and in uniform here tonight. Winnick into the Columbus zone, fires, and a glove save by Bobrovsky. First power play chance for Minnesota tonight. Zucker, Koivu, Ennis up front for the Wild. Zucker plays it across. Spurgeon fires, and a blocker saved by Bobrovsky. Suter to Spurgeon. Back for Ennis. A shot, he scores!
Well, you talked a little bit about how long that stick is for Ennis. Watch how he uses it here. He shoots it away from his body, gets a little bit of an extension there, and that's tough for the goaltender to adjust the angle.
Just 35 seconds after Eric Staal's goal, Zach Werenski tied it. A turnover. Mitchell for Ferraro. He fires. It's loose behind Bobrovsky. They score! Landon Ferraro knocks the puck in, and the Wild have a two-goal lead. Two-goal lead for Minnesota. Koivu plays it ahead for Zucker. He has Ennis with him. Zucker in to Ennis off his skate. Never got a shot away. Before he was born, and now we're on the same line here tonight. Savard scores on a shot from just inside the line over the shoulder of Dubnyk. And the Blue Jackets once again have answered a Minnesota goal, cutting the Wild lead to 3-2. Staal sweeps one cross ice for Winnick. They're good at the line. Winnick stood up just inside the Columbus blue line. Tries to center. Spurgeon lost the handle on it as Cullen came away with the puck. We get the whistle. Spurgeon able to maintain the zone. Koivu back to Spurgeon. Now they'll get it set up the right way with Koivu working The half wall works his way in, fires on goal, and a save by Bobrovsky. Dubois works his way out of the corner. He's watched by Suter. Hands it back to Johnson. Johnson works his way free, and his shot is knocked away by Dubnyk. To Zucker, back to Koivu. Across for Spurgeon. Thought about a shot, instead goes to Suter. Now Koivu. Deflected by Ennis, they score! Another power play goal for Ennis, and Minnesota leads 4-2.
I'm not so sure that Koivu wasn't trying to hit Spurgeon on the back door. Spurgeon is all the way across. There's a bit of a screen there by Zucker, who gains good position, and it just gets underneath Bobrovsky.
It's confirmed it's a good goal.
Should have plenty of hockey logic on the Wild Live postgame show tonight. Dubnyk with a save, rebound, they score. Good effort by Atkinson. Dubnyk stopped him on the initial shot, but then Atkinson able to put the rebound into the net. And again, Columbus has a quick answer to a Minnesota goal, and the lead is 4-3.
The power play goals there by Ennis.
Spurgeon back to pick it up. Long shot gloved by Dubnyk, and he hangs on. Werenski back to Wenberg. Now to Werenski in the middle. Across for Panarin, and a one-timer hits the post. Jones back to Foligno. Now to Jones, a shot, and that goes wide. Zucker racing after it for Minnesota. Can he beat Werenski to the outside? Drives to the middle. It's off the crossbar, and they score.
They're waving it off on the ice. They're saying no goal on the ice. Here's the shot. It looked like it may have caught the blade there of Werenski. And right off the crossbar. What a shot, though, by Zucker, and an even better move.
The video review, the puck hits the crossbar and never enters the net, we have no goal.
Savard works his way toward the goal. A shot. Save Dubnyk. He was trying to cover the rebound, could not get there quickly enough. Lands on the stick of Koivu, but his shot was blocked. Milano got a piece of it. Here comes Dubinsky. His long shot knocked away by Dubnyk, who batted the rebound out of midair.
Having everyone else there.
Savard shot scores. Dubnyk arguing immediately. It looked like it changed direction on the way. We'll have to wait to see if it was a high stick or not. But Savard's shot finds the back of the net, and Columbus is tied at 4-4.
It did catch a stick on the way through.
Didn't look like a high stick.
The original call that was made on the ice is going to stand. You have a good goal.
Crowd wanted a penalty, nothing coming, and Panarin emerges with the puck. Got it ahead to Jones at center. Koivu off for Minnesota as Wenberg carries in. Panarin drives to the middle. Still with it. Fires. Saved by Dubnyk. Rebound, they score. And again, Dubnyk is arguing.
Here's a good angle off the blocker. And yeah, it looks like it was shoveled forward with the gloves. I think he's got a point there.
The goaltender makes the save. The puck comes out, hits the belly, hits the shaft of the stick, and goes in the net. It's a good hockey goal.
So the overtime winner for Columbus spoils the home opener for Minnesota. And the Wild now 14-0-3 all time in their home openers in St. Paul.